Good evening. Welcome to worship as we conclude our day of rest, our day of praising God. Let's hear from him as he calls us to himself. These are the words from Psalm 148. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord. Join me in prayer. God, we know that the best thing for us is to praise you, for we were created to worship you. We were created in your image in good, righteous relationship with you, and you have restored us to that relationship. And we know that as you call us to worship, this is the thing for which our soul longs and the thing for which we wander looking for satisfaction in until we find it in you. And so we pray, God, as we gather around your word, gather to pray, gather to sing, gather ultimately to meet with you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we ask that you would, gracious God, send the Holy Spirit to stir in our hearts and enable us to praise you as we ought, as a rational response to the gospel. We pray you would send your Spirit to enable us to praise you in spirit and in truth, and to praise you knowing that someday we will not only praise you by faith, but we will praise you by sight. And we pray that that day would come quickly. And we ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen.
this prayer of confession. Our Father, giver of every perfect gift, we confess that our souls have not been fully satisfied in you. We covet honor and possessions, envy those who have what we do not, and are prone to complain under our circumstances. Please forgive our ingratitude, O God. Grant us the joy which comes from your Holy Spirit, that we might find our deepest longings met in you. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now hear the assurance of the gospel that is given to us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God didn't send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Once again, let's unite our hearts together in prayer. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, how we rejoice to come into your presence. How we enjoy being able to worship you and to meet with you, to meet with the living God, to hear you speak to us through your word and by your spirit. Lord, we come now asking that you indeed will have your word, your voice heard in our presence. But most of all, we crave that our lives may be changed because of the time we spend with you. Challenge us, encourage us, alter our lives that they may become more like your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. For it is in his precious name that we pray. Amen. Our reading today is from Matthew chapter 13, rather a long section, but they're all on the same theme, parables of the kingdom. Jesus put another parable before them, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while his men were sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds also appeared. And the servant of the master of the house came and said to him, 'Master, did not you sow good seed in your field? How then does it have weeds?' And he said to them, 'An enemy has done this.' So the servant said to him, 'Then do you want us to go and gather them?' But he said, 'No, lest in gathering the weeds you root up the wheat along with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at the harvest time I will tell the reapers, gather the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn.' He put another parable before them, saying, 'The kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed that a man took and sowed in his field. It's the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it's larger than all the garden plants and becomes a tree so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches.' He told them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like leaven that a woman took and hid in 3 measures of flour till it was all leavened. All these things Jesus said to the crowds in parables. Indeed, he said nothing to them without a parable. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet, 'I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter what has been hidden since the foundation of the world.' Then he left the crowds and went into the house. And his disciples came to him, saying, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field.' He answered, 'The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed is the sons of the kingdom. The weeds are the sons of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are gathered and burned with fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all lawbreakers, and throw them into the fiery furnace. In that place, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. From the Shorter Catechism. Question 24. How does Christ execute the office of a prophet? Christ executes the office of a prophet in revealing to us by his word and spirit the will of God for our salvation. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you again that you have made your will known. And we thank you that you have prescribed the way we can worship you. We give of the monies that you have made available to us, not only to demonstrate our stewardship with your finances, but also out of our deep love. We pray that you would use them so many may come to know of you through our sharing, through others who are sharing in many cultures around this world, so that many will come to praise us along with you. For it is in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we ask this. Amen. Please be seated.